You have to imagine a top spinning along the ground. The faster it is, it's standing straight up. It's symmetrical. That's a Category 5 hurricane. But as it begins to slow down or decrease in intensity, it'll start to warble. It moves a lot. And that really determines how rough a flight you're going to have. Well, I got my degree in meteorology from Florida State University. Did weather for active duty military for about 5 years, and then became an Air Force Reserve hurricane hunter. I have over 1,000 hours flying in the WC-130H and J. Every storm is different. Every storm has a personality. I think that's part of the reason why they give them different names. The way I look at it, if you fly through the eye of a hurricane and don't believe in God at that point, I don't see how you can afterwards. Let's say you go to a doctor and you have a tumor, some growth inside your body. You want to know what it is. You're concerned. Is it dangerous or is it not? So you go to the doctor, they take an x-ray. What is an x-ray going to tell you? It's going to tell you you got a tumor. But is it cancerous? Is it malignant? Is it just a cyst? You don't know. The only thing a doctor can do to find out is to take a biopsy. We're doing the same thing inside of a hurricane because we're the biopsy of that storm. We can give you that sample that tell our experts at the Hurricane Center what the storm is, what it's going to do. It gives you the complete sample of that hurricane. There are critical decisions our leaders have to make, whether they're evacuating personnel, our aircraft to different locations, or depend heavily on the reserve citizen airmen and their collection of data that makes that forecast more reliable. How important is weather to the overall Air Force mission? How important is weather to the overall Department of Defense mission? Maybe one battle, one war, that weather didn't play a part. Anything else?